Hello and Namaste everyone. Welcome back to our channel, The Gyan Center. This is Rosina Khadka and today is our second video on the IELTS course. Now, we covered the introduction part on our previous video and today we'll be going forward with the detailed explanation on one of those very modules. But before we do that, let's do a quick recap. So IELTS stands for the International English Language Testing System, which is calculated on a 9-man scale to measure the language proficiency of people applying abroad. And we have two kinds of IELTS, and I'll be starting with IELTS Academic. Alright, let's get into it. So IELTS is more or less like studying English. Then what makes a difference to the general English course? Actually, it's nothing more than the content, the techniques, and it's definitely more trickier. So if we know the techniques, tips and tricks and guidelines to tackle the contents of IELTS, we'll realize that it is easier than what we make of it. Okay, now we also discuss the contents of IELTS. There are four components of IELTS: listening, reading, writing and speaking. And we'll start with listening. So listening is one of the four modules of IELTS, and listening test is conducted on the same day as reading and writing. And there are four parts to IELTS listening test. Each part is about a different topic and gets increasingly more difficult. The first audio is usually an informal dialogue in a social or everyday situation. For example, a conversation about opening a bank account or someone inquiring about accommodation or a training course and so on. The second audio is usually on a non-academic monologue. It could be a person giving information on something such as a guided museum tour, information about a conference or a tourist information, and likewise. The third audio is usually a discussion between 3 to 4 people. It can be related to education or training, and it may be a discussion between 2 students and a tutor or colleagues or just a group assignment. And the fourth and the final audio is usually a university style lecture, and it could be related to any academic topic. Now, I guess you understand what I mean by it gets increasingly more difficult. You know, you can just get by the context of the different parts that I just discussed. Now, the test is like for 40 minutes, the total test time, and 30 minutes of listening and 10 minutes of the time is for you to transfer your answers from the listening booklet to answer sheet. So there will be total of 40 questions. Guys, please remember that the IELTS listening answer sheet is very important piece of paper. Your IELTS listening score, it is calculated according to what you've written on that very answer sheet. So therefore, you have to make sure you completed your answer sheet before the end of the time allocated and filled it in correctly. Okay, one thing I have realized is many people say that it is one of the easier sections in IELTS, maybe even the most easy among all sections, since all you need to do really is to listen to the audio and answer the questions, which actually does sound fairly easy if you see it that way. And that might be the case for some of you. But a lot of us, we do struggle with understanding the accents that's used, or not knowing the synonyms to even keep up with the pace of the recording, or not being able to figure out the paraphrase sentences and so on. Hence, I am here to help you provide guidelines to tackle all those issues and help you get the score that you're aiming for. Now, let's get started with some of the important IELTS listening tips that you need to remember. Tip number one, you will be given some time to read the questions before each recording is played. Read the questions very carefully, as you will hear each recording only once, so you want to be familiar with the questions before you hear the recording. So basically, what I mean by this is that you need to read the questions before each recording. Just say हजुरहरुले चाहिँ रेकर्डिङ प्ले गर्नुभन्दा अगाडि अलिकति टाइम पाउनुहुन्छ जसमा चाहिँ इट्स इम्पोर्टेन्ट कि तपाईँले त्यो क्वेसन्सहरू चाहिँ एकचोटि खरेर एकचोटि हेर्नुहोस् सो द्याट युआर फमिलियर विथ कस्तो कस्तो खालको क्वेसन्सहरू छ कसरी ट्याकल गर्ने भन्ने अलिकति भए पनि इजी होस् भनेर चाहिँ त्यो टाइमलाई युटिलाइज गर्नु होला अलवेज रिमेम्बर द्याट है अलराइट टिप नम्बर 2 एज यु लिसन write your answers and then transfer them at the end of the listening test. You will be given extra 10 minutes to do this. But be sure that you check that you've answered your questions and you've all of them, and you've transferred it correctly accordingly. And you make sure to you check your spelling and grammar, and that is very important. So तपाईँहरूले चाहिँ जब आफ्नो टाइममा जब बुकलेटमा एन्सर्सहरू लेखेर भ्याइसक्नुभयो त्यही चिजलाई 10 मिनट्स एक्स्ट्रा दिन्छ हजुरलाई त्योलाई ट्रान्सफर गर्नलाई. त्यो ट्रान्सफर गर्ने बेलामा चाहिँ एकचोटि मजाले नै करेक्टली ट्रान्सफर गरिराख्नु भएको छ कि छैन र स्पेलिङहरू र ग्रामरहरू चाहिँ चेक गरेर नै ट्रान्सफर गर्नुहोला. अलवेज रिमेम्बर टु डु द्याट है. टिप नम्बर 3, you don't have to worry if you don't understand everything you hear. Listen out for the keywords from the questions and focus on what you need to be listening out for. So hajurle worry garnu pardaina if hajur harule sabai ramro sang suniraknu bhayaina bhane. Tara yaad garnu parne chiz chai keywords haru ho. Jastai booklet ma hajur ko thaka keywords haru ke cha tyo anusar chai recording sunnu paryo. So hajurle sunda khari chai specific आन्सर्सको लागि रेकर्डिङ सुन्ने, गीत सुने यसरी चाहिँ सुन्ने होइन. बिकज समराइज भनेर आउँदैन, ठ्याक्क ठ्याक्क क्वेसन्सहरू सोधिएको हुन्छ र त्यो त्यो ठाउँमा त्यो आन्सर भेटिनु पर्यो. सो त्यही अनुसार हजुरले फोकस गर्नु पर्यो है. अलराइट, नाउ टिप नम्बर 4 इज इफ यु मिस अ क्वेसन प्लिज डोन्ट ड्वेल अन इट बिकज यु मे मिस द आन्सर टु द नेक्स्ट वान. सो इफ यु मिस जस्ट मुभ अन. सो एउटा काहीँ हजुरको क्वेसन मिस भइहाल्यो भने चाहिँ त्यसमै अड्केर नबस्दिनु होला. त्यो भयो भने हजुरले अरू क्वेसन्सहरू पनि मिस गर्नुहुन्छ बिकज मैले भनिसकेँ रेकर्डिङ फेरि फेरि प्ले हुँदैन. सो एकचोटि मिस भयो भने जस्ट मुभ अन टु नेक्स्ट वान. नाउ टिप नम्बर 5 इज मेक स्योर यु फलो द वर्ड काउन्ट इन द इन्स्ट्रक्सन्स अफ इच क्वेसन. फर एक्जाम्पल, इफ द इन्स्ट्रक्सन्स से राइट नो मोर देन वान वर्ड एन्ड यु राइट टु वर्ड्स लाइक आन्सर्समा आन्सर चाहिँ ट्रेन मात्रै, तर तपाईँले द ट्रेन भनेर लेखिदिनु भयो बिकज त्यहाँ माथि इन्स्ट्रक्सन राम्रोसँग पढ्नु भएन भन्ने त्यो रङ भयो. सो इन्स्ट्रक्सन्स राम्रोसँग पढ्नलाई एकदमै इम्पोर्टेन्ट छ. अलराइट, ओके. नाउ टिप नम्बर 6 इज देयर इज नो नेगेटिभ मार्किङ. सो यु विल जस्ट गेट अ जिरो फर इनकरेक्ट ओर इनकम्प्लिट आन्सर. वाट आई मिन बाई दिस इज इफ यु मिस आर क्वेसन या इन्कम्प्लिट छोडिदिनु भयो भने त्यसमा पनि जिरो नै आउने हो. सो सकेसम्म सबै क्वेसन्सहरू अटेम्प्ट गर्नुहोला. यो हो जस्तो लागेको छ भने पनि मेबी युज यु गेस वर्क, बट ट्राई एन्ड नट लिभ आउट द क्वेसन्स एम्प्टी सिन्स देयर इज नो नेगेटिभ मार्किङ. द लास्ट स्टेप इज ओल्वेज क्रस चेक युर आन्सर्स. प्लिज क्रस चेक युर आन्सर्स. इट्स भेरी इम्पोर्टेन्ट इन ओल द टेस्ट द्याट यु डु. कि एकचोटि यु मेक स्योर कि बुकलेटसँग एकचोटि राम्रोसँग चेक गर्नु, कुनै तलमाथि भएको छ कि केही सानोतिनो मिस्टेक भएको छ कि भनेर त्यसलाई क्रस चेक गर्नु चाहिँ एकदमै इम्पोर्टेन्ट छ. ओके, फ्यु अर द इम्पोर्टेन्ट थिङ्स टु रिमेम्बर इज इफ यु क्यानट हियर द अडियो प्रपरली लेट अ मेम्बर अफ स्टाफ नो स्ट्रेट अवे. केही सुन्नु भएको छैन राम्रोसँग भने प्लिज भनिदिइहाल्नु होला. अल्सो प्लिज ट्राई एन्ड एन्टिसिपेट वाट द स्पिकर विल से. आई थिङ्क द्याट विल रियली रियली हेल्प. अब यो पछि के भन्छ होला भनेर आफ्नो त्यो किवर्डको बुकलेटको हिसाबमा अलिकति एन्टिसिपेट गर्न सक्नुभयो भने त्यसले पनि आन्सर ठ्याक्क काहीँ मिलिरहेको छैन जस्तो रङ भइरहेछ कि राइट भइरहेछ भन्ने चिज चाहिँ तपाईँलाई फिगर आउट गर्न आई थिङ्क इट विल हेल्प अ लट. अल्सो बिकज युर रिडिङ एन्ड राइटिङ एन्ड लिसनिङ एट द सेम टाइम यु हेभ टु किप युर माइन्ड शार्प. यु कान्ट गेट बोर्ड लाइक वेन युर लिसनिङ द अडियो. सो एकदम शार्प माइन्ड राखेर सुन्नु होला है. आई थिङ्क दोज आर द बेसिक टिप्स द्याट यु निड टु रिमेम्बर वेन युआर अपियरिङ फर द आइएल्स टेस्ट. नाउ अल्सो जस्ट ब्रिफली डिस्कसिङ अबाउट द टाइप्स अफ क्वेसन्स द्याट यु विल सी इन आइएल्स लिसनिङ. वान इज मल्टिपल चोइस क्वेसन्स. I'm sure you know what that means, like you have to choose between maybe ABC, ABCD. So yesari nai choice haru options haru madhe euta choose garnu parne bhayo. Short answer questions, like maybe one word, two word, three words khalko short answer questions haru hun sakcha. Sentence completion, which is basically you completing the sentence, fill in the blanks jasto bhayo. Sometimes it will be true or false also. And it may be there are like notes, summary, plan, diagram, table, chart, khalko completion or isto tackle boxes or ma ya to kunai labeling khalko questions or pani auna sakcha. Hey, classification is the other kind of questions. Classify garera tackle sodne bhayo ra matching kunai pani chiz lai match garnu parne. So these are the kinds of questions that you will be getting in IELTS Listening. Now, the preparation part. How do you prepare for IELTS Listening? The key point in preparation for IELTS Listening test is practice. I know, guys, that it sounds very obvious, but that is what it is, that you have to practice. So it's a very good strategy to listen to English speech as often as you can. Now, there are ways to do that. You may watch your favorite TV programs in English songs. You can hear them and you can watch any videos, but make sure that you watch them in English that might interest you. Ask play interest like your kune bini videos. There is a English man. And we watch a lot of English movies, read a lot of English novels, short stories and so on. And most importantly, you have to remember that you appear for IELTS mock test sort of say dine garnus, so that you can analyze where you are exactly making mistakes. Then after you've done that, you can practice a lot of other IELTS exercises that'll help you develop your own techniques. Besides the tips and tricks that I've given you, you might develop your own techniques to tackle the questions. I think we just finished our first component of IELTS, just basic discussion on it. I hope that this was helpful, and let me know if you have any queries regarding IELTS Listening that I did not address here. Hope you guys liked the video. Please hit the like button if you did, and make sure you leave your feedbacks on our comment section below. I'll be back with my next video on IELTS reading. Until then, subscribe and make sure you hit the bell icon to get notified of all our videos as soon as we post them. Thank you for watching, guys. Until next time, bye bye.